Hello students, I am Dr. Tanmoy Vishwas. I welcome you all in my channel Chemistry, the Mystery of Molecules. So today we will discuss our detection test. Okay, so today's topic is detection of CC double bond by two tests. One is Bayer test, means cold alkaline KMnO4. Second one is bromine water test. So both you can say similar type, but although there are some differences, so we will discuss these two. So today's discussion will cover few points like the basic idea, what intermediates means reagents, what and the intermediate and limitations of this process, and my some completely personal comments of mine. So I believe up to these limitations this is fine for your examination, but my comments part you can listen, you not, but the completely mine. But I feel as a teacher I should say you what's my personal opinion or feelings about this chemistry. Okay, so let's start. Okay, so as you can see, actually this is a CC double bond. Double bond means that this is a sigma bond and along with that a pi bond. Okay, so this is the sigma bond and this is the pi bond. So this pi bond is weaker in nature because this parallel overlap, okay, or sidewise overlap. So that is the reason reaction is happening on the pi bond. So first reaction is a pi bond reaction. So what happens? So left side cold alkaline KMnO4, what it result? It results in a cis diol formation, not only diol. Always keep it in mind, cis diol. I know. Actually, in this video, I am not going to explain the mechanism in details. So, I will explain very soon about the another video of details mechanism. Just it's a short video, so please don't confuse. We will have this details very soon. Fine, it's a cis diol. And what is the fate of this? Because see, its manganese is +7, or better to say, you can write in this way +7 oxidation state. What happens about manganese? It forms MnO2. Manganese is +4 oxidation state. This is so. This is the thing it produces. Why cold alkaline? And another thing, diluted. Cold diluted. Why? First of all, if you increase temperature increase or concentration of KMnO4, if you increase, then there is a chance of mixture of product, or better to say oxidized product. Why? Because KMnO4 is a very strong oxidant. So if you put relatively harsh condition, so what it does that it will produce diol, but diol will not stop at this stage. Okay, so what it will do, it will produce variety of other oxidized products. Okay, so this part we understood that it will result. And another thing is, what is the intermediate? It's a very important thing. So intermediate of this reaction is a ester, better to say OOMN. This. Okay, see, 4 oxygen, better the way to keep remember it, 4 oxygen there, here is 4 oxygen. There was a double bond, just double bond is attached to oxygen, so this. So under alkaline hydrolysis, so this is actually a ester. Ester between this alcohol means diol means an alcohol and manganese. Okay, so this is a metal containing ester. Hydrolysis means you can think that it's hydrolyzed and produces this, and actually it's a cis diol. So ultimately in this way this cis diol is produced. This is the simplest thing. Mechanism I will explain in some next video. In case of bromine water, what happened? So this bromine water produces transdibromide, it's a simple addition reaction. Okay, so this. Now, what is the interesting point? An intermediate? Intermediate is a bridge, bromonium ion. I have already discussed this part in details previously. Sorry. So please visit those video if you want to learn in details. Opens up and closes. Fine. So this is the overall mechanism. Means a very short mechanism. Now question. Detection test. When we say a word detection test, what do we mean? We mean that we can detect the thing visually. Okay. So what is the visual change actually happening? See, alkene, it is colorless. Generally colorless. Fine. Bromine water, if you check its color, it's reddish brown. It's reddish brown. And the final dibromide, this is also colorless. So what do I mean? That if you mix a reddish brown solution with a colorless material, and ultimately getting colorless. So that's the proof of unsaturation. Here, this K1O4 is a pink color. Pink color. So it's a pink color material, diol, this is colorless. But one thing, this MnO, this is not colorless, these are black particles. But I would not suggest you that you make comment based on this, because very dilute cold, so you may not visualize this thing properly. So it is better not to focus on this. Better from pink color to colorless. This is the observation. So this supports completely the presence of double bond. Fine. So now, so what we have about this colorless? Okay, we have discussed the reagents. Fine. Limitation. Let's come to the limitation. So limitation of this methods. First of all, see this bromine test. If there is an another reaction from bromine. What do I mean? If you take aniline or phenol, just I am writing in this way. So what happened? And if you put bromine water, what is the product? The product is tri-bromophenol or aniline plus 3 molecule HCl. This is aromatic electrophilic substitution. Why this happened? Because these nucleus are very electron rich. Consequently, that's why they can react with direct bromine molecule. Better to say this. No need of any Lewis acid, because aromatic electrophilic substitution, we have observed that we need a Lewis acid. Because of the electron means rich nature or activating nature, that's why it don't need so this. But question, if you have given a simple alkene with aniline or phenol, how to distinguish? The answer is, you can distinguish. How? First of all, you have given these two product. So product A means this is A and this is B. B. Add bromine water. And you get colorless. Fine. That is the observation. But in case of B, there is HBr. But in case of A, no acid is produced. So how can you detect this HBr? You can detect this by litmus test. Litmus test. Because litmus test became red. Okay. Acid red. How to remember? Acid D is there. Red D is there. Okay, so in this way you can remember this factor. So this is the exception. There is some another thing or another my comment, as I told. So this is the overall discussion for this Bayer test and bromine test. This is the complete for your exam. So enough. But I have some of my comment. So if you want, you may listen. What is my comment? My comment is, see, we are actually dealing CC pi bond, okay, carbon-carbon pi bond, but that not be aromatic. That's the condition. And by the way, another important information. So aromatic compound, for example, benzene. If you put bromine water or KMnO4 or KMnO4 means this Bayer test, alkaline KMnO4 cold, don't know reaction. This is another information. Okay, so please keep it in mind that aromatic hydrocarbon you can't detect. Their exception is this phenol and aniline. Okay, fine. Now, some comments. Comment means, suppose you have alkyne. This is alkyne. Will it give these two tests? Actually, they will give. So, both test is positive. Fine. See, if you see CC double bond, this pi bond, this is relatively weak. And if you see, there are two pi bonds, and this the second pi bond is further weak. And proof of this concept is that using Lindler catalyst, you can reduce, you can stop ultimately in the intermediate stage. Okay, means it's a relatively less reactive activated catalyst. So I have made a video about Lindler catalyst. Please visit if you want. So fine. So this proves that this second double bond is very active. So it will instantly react with both. So is there any way to distinguish? Or is there any way to prove that whether it's not alkene or alkyne? One thing I can say that if you have terminal hydrogen, this is the terminal hydrogen, or better to say, this is a terminal alkyne. If you have terminal alkyne, then you can do, you can react with silver plus or copper plus. And in case of this, what it produces? This. Sorry. This is the acetylide. So, this is one of the things. But, if you say about internal alkyne, is it possible? Using this method, it is not possible to detect it properly. Okay, there are lots of confusion we created. So, my opinion is that this test are very easy, visually detectable, this as well as this. But you can't do this. So that's why I told, this is my personal opinion or comment. It is not essential that you learn, but I think I should give you the information. So this is the overall discussion about this video, and this is the end of this lecture. So what we have learned today? We have learned today about the detection of unsaturation using Baird test, means cold alkaline KMnO4, as well as bromine water test. And exception like the reaction with this aminine, aniline, phenol, etc. And what is the consequences. So thank you everyone for listening. If you think this video is really helpful for you, please help me to grow and motivate me to upload such type of video on a regular interval. So if you really want to do, first I request you, please subscribe my channel at Chemistry and History of Molecule, and please press the bell icon to get the notification of every single video I upload. Secondly, share this video among your friends. I think many people will be benefited from my effort and I will be very happy. And most importantly, please like the video and make some good comments. It is a motivation for me to upload many videos for you. And surprisingly or interestingly, if you have any comments, opinion, criticism, please feel free to hesitate. Please feel free, don't hesitate to mention it in the comment box. Your opinion, suggestion, comments will help me to improve, and in future you will get better quality videos. So thank you again. Stay happy, stay blessed. God bless you.